Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back once again to more Blood Bowl. We are in the finals of the Bucket League, and I somehow made it past the final, the semi-final of Dan, and I'm facing more elves in the face of Oh Lawlth. Hello, Mr. Nick.
Hello. I am also surprised, considering that in the original... This is actually kind of interesting for me, because in the original tournament, I lost to everyone except you.
Yeah.
I'm feeling kind of confident.
Thanks for that.
You're the only person I beat.
Then again.
Yeah, but didn't I get fucked by dice against you?
Could happen again.
But yeah, that happens again. In every single game, someone gets fucked by dice.
True.
That's how Blood Bowl works.
Well, that's not strictly true. You cannot get fucked by dice and just get fucked by the other person because they're better than you.
I want to see, like, because this wouldn't be possible within the frames of the computer game, but get, like, on the board games, play a game and assume that every possible block and situation goes exactly like the person who wants it to go goes, and see how that goes.
You have an invitation that's going to expire in a minute, bro.
You have 30 seconds to shoot the shit, then.
What's the team value difference?
50.
I have two journeymen.
He's got two journeymen. I have... one.
So yeah, but how much pay cash? Yeah, you're going to get a silly amount of pay cash, aren't you?
No, because I've only got 20k myself. I was 50 down from you.
You've got 100 grand. So you've got to re-roll.
I will say, I'm not going to say any spoilers in this pod, obviously, but I will say one of the games that the stream just watched, there was a petty cash differential of 450,000.
So it was glorious.
But 50 of those were your own money.
It was, but it's still 450,000 difference.
So I have to wait a minute and a half for Nick to decide how he's going to agonizingly spend his 100 grand.
Nah, it's basically, do I want extra reroll? Do I want double blood wiser, babe?
You can do an extra Apo as well.
Apo 60k? There's 100,000.
No, Apo's 100. Reroll on Apo 100. Bloodwisers are 50 each.
How many rerolls has Nick got?
Three
now, yeah.
Apo, oh, three's tough. If it's two, I'd definitely say reroll. Three is, I think, the ideal.
Yeah, I'm gonna go for double Bloodwiser.
It is nice because you do get the wake up at a 2+.
Yep. I've been screwed over by people not waking up so much that I'm gonna go for the double Bloodwiser.
You have one of them.
Okay then.
Yeah, I will say the devastation you feel when your guys just roll ones anyway, and you're just like, I hate you.
I'm expecting that. I am totally expecting that. Believe me.
Setting yourself up for misery.
Yep. All right, Bucket League time.
Bucket League.
Let me know when you guys have got the flip, and I will look for the game.
Yep.
A game to decide the best of the worst. Nick, are you ready?
The way game.
Welcome back to best of the bucket.
The best of the worst.
Hey, Pete. Hey Pete, if you win this, I'll bring you a bucket at Coxcon.
You bring me a bucket?
Yeah, I'll give you a bucket for winning the Bucket League.
Thanks, man.
The Bucket League? What happens then?
Metal or plastic?
I'll give you a bucket next time I see you, which might be like years.
Cool. Hopefully not.
Well, Lucas said it was plastic or metal.
I'm assuming
it'll be the cheapest possible bucket I can find.
Plastic.
Probably, it'll be like a tiny plastic bucket.
It's like a teeny little, like, hand-sized one. That's better, though, because it's like a trophy.
Okay, I can write
on it in, like, with a Sharpie and write, like, Bucket League on it.
We're setting up, Josh.
Yeah, I'm in.
Number one.
Facing the Dark Elves. They're cruel, they're vicious, and they're really pretty good.
How's everyone doing today?
Hey.
I'm astounded.
Oh shit, you have Claw again. I forgot you had Claw.
Yes.
It's a thing.
It's actually useful against elves. Or these elves, anyway.
Where's the other fucking one? Wait. I had two journeymen. Where's the other fucker?
Where are we up to?
Yeah, you swapped them around. You literally just changed them places. You want more frontroids. One more guy front and center, please.
I assume Nick is receiving.
Yeah.
Oh, that's sized.
What was that?
I noticed he had sidestep on a blodge piece.
Yeah, it's pretty sick.
Blodge sidestep. It's funny you can actually just use it to move up the pitch as well now.
Yeah, could sidestep it. Sidestep is really strong.
Push to, it's literally any free square.
Mm-hmm. I really like, in my high elf team that I have, that hasn't really played against humans, like, I did it in the AI League just to kind of play in AI League and try and see what happened. Both my high elf blitzers have dodge, block, and sidestep, and it's incredible, like, how much they can sort of weave their way through stuff when they get pushed.
That's a pretty elfy line, I'll be honest with you.
Well, he's playing elves. Pretty elfy, or no other pieces.
He sure is playing 100% elves in his team.
They have to.
I'm just waiting for the fucking blitz stab on the Minotaur.
I really wish he'd played Greg. It would have been so good against that Trollslayer.
The Armor 7 Trollslayer, yeah. That Armor 7 actually like came back to bite him quite a few times because I would consistently tried to hit that guy with Mighty Blow.
Oh, for God's sake.
I mean, I'm glad I don't have to do any more games with that Skaven team, and or could put them in another league, because I now have an Armor 6 niggled gutter run.
Yes, well.
Fine. At least it's not raining. There's no weather to start off, which is good. Do it again.
I hate bad puns. I haven't learned my lesson, you realize this, right?
I was going to say, like, what the fuck, you hit...
I've not learned my lesson.
No, you haven't. Not even remotely.
Nope.
Just started your turn with hitting with the witch elf.
Yep.
You haven't learned any
no lessons to me.
Oh my god.
In the face. Oh, he's already stunned. Fine, you paved the way for the assassin.
Whoopee-dee-doo.
Shut up, Jim.
Did you get the same thing, did you?
Yep. Like, Jim, goddammit. Go away.
I do think you should get SPP for stabs.
I think you should get at least one.
No.
I'm not sure about stabs.
My assassin's literally done nothing. He's got zero SPP.
He has done stuff, though.
He's gotten a couple of nice stabs.
He's stabbed, yes, but a couple of nice stabs don't get him anything.
I know, that's what I said to you, and you were just like, it's fine.
It is fine, but I would wish it did a little bit more.
Yeah. Assassins are fun, but they're just not really good. What injuries do you have again? You have an Armor 7 guy, right?
Oh, come on, this was meant to be bloody...
You know what?
Well, that's good. It's good in a way.
Oh!
There it is!
Oh!
Saxon, you're useless. That was meant to be a stab as well.
Yeah.
I'm like... I honestly don't know, like, how you do a stab, so I can't help you either.
You click on the guy and select stab.
Yeah.
I do think it should be like, you basically set the path when you click on the enemy, it tells you what you should do. Like, and if you haven't moved that turn, it lets be a blitz, or whatever. Quick, make a cage around the Minotaur.
Well, I will say the chat is enjoying. I don't know why, I was just kind of expecting both downs.
Ooh.
Oh, but doesn't your guy have Juggernaut?
Yeah.
Yeah,
so
yep.
Closest thing to don't do that.
To block that you can get, yeah.
Except for, you know, block.
Yeah, but he needs doubles to get block.
Oh yeah, it's like you can't guarantee it, but you can get block.
I'm not saying I can't, I'm just saying like I didn't roll doubles so I got Juggernaut. I went for the completely non-fun build.
Yep. See, I went for the fun build in the finals, and I got punished for it.
Oh, you got it.
apart from the bit where you won, yeah. Yeah, you got punished.
Why would you spoil things?
Because he's maddened. Well, the assassin's off, and the witch elf is down for a turn. I'd say that's a pretty successful turn.
The assassin being off is more.
I got SPP for it.
No, yeah, I know. I'm just saying the assassin being off is better though, because the witch elf is worthless. She doesn't do shit.
She sleeps.
Smack. Yeah, that's what she. She is good at sleeping.
She does really sleep good. Around a lot. Yeah.
Like really good.
She's really good at sleeping.
Yep.
My loners like to sleep as well.
I think everyone's loners like to sleep.
Because we put them on the fucking pits.
Yeah, but it doesn't. That's not going to equal them getting stunned all the time.
It does increase.
That's true. That beastman might be taking a nap.
No, because he's not a loner.
Oh, is that minus AV elf?
Yeah, he's got a few injuries. I think there's a niggle on here as well.
Yeah. There's a niggle somewhere.
Oh, minus movement on that elf. There's minus AV on another one of them. Yeah. And then there's a niggle on one of them? Yeah, minus AV as well. So you've got two armor 7 blitzers, one movement 6 blitzer. Like, your blitzers have taken a real pounding.
Yes, they have. They've done their job, to be honest. So, blitzers supposed to be taking a pounding, they just got hurt while doing so.
So this is what we call the elf shovel.
Yeah, but I've been slowly redefining elf meta as I played the season, so it's fine.
It's true. At the same time, like, Lucas has been completely shattering human meta in every way possible.
winning.
For God's sake, we saw the innovation and execution of the fucking corridor strat. I didn't even know what that was. The corridor strat. Do you not remember? It was against Greg, I think.
I'll take that.
Yeah, he wasn't here, though.
Oh, Ronnie, did you not see the corridor strat?
No.
So the corridor strat basically was Lucas forcing his way down the middle of the pitch and just pushing all the dwarfs into their own side ends. So it was literally a corridor of humans taking over the dwarfs' pitch.
That's kind of amazing.
Yeah. it was just these two lines of humans just stopping the dwarfs getting into the middle.
Did it work?
Yeah, it did.
Scored.
Nice.
So but I did the thing.
He was expecting the spearhead. That's why.
No, I did a stupid thing to try it again when he had the death roller on the pitch.
That did not work out for you.
That did not work.
No.
I mean, I like this commitment to trying to get Negabeef off the field, Nick. I like the commitment.
Really? I failed the jump up. Are you kidding me?
Well, you failed the jump up blitz, didn't you? Oh, so you can't get up at all?
Yeah, yep. if you fail the jump up when you've issued like a jump up block, if you fail it, she stays on her ass.
Oh,
because
that's interesting.
The idea is...
I thought I was expecting it to default to a blitz, but it didn't, so...
No, because basically the idea is if you want a guaranteed jump up, just jump up. If you want to block and jump up, then they make it like it's risky. So if it fails, you don't get to jump up, which it kind of makes sense. Like, it gives the skill an actual, like, you know, risk to it. Yeah. Because you could just blitz with her. If you definitely want her to jump up and hit, you can guaranteed with the blitz. Right now, Nick is executing what we call the enlarged tetramino attack.
Yeah, I was about to say, like, we are just imposing on a Tetris block over here.
Was it you, Lucas, who was using the tetramino attack all the time that I kept calling it?
You called my corridor strat for that.
Oh yeah, your setup for it just looked like the tetramino attack. Oh my God, Thomas bought Blood Bowl. Oh God,
really?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Wow.
Oh, God.
So I'm guessing he's joining us for next season then. I have 10 players.
I'm
I mean, I would gladly fucking play with them, but oh my god.
Thomas is far too dice drunk. We just lose. Thomas is the next victor.
Admittedly, I think it would be very awesome if he won.
Yeah, I will say, like, Thomas definitely has dice size, but he also has to work out how Blood Bowl works. And exactly. Blood Bowl, as people know, is a very archaic and mystical thing.
My screen there. It looked like basically.
Yeah, it looked like it was dodging in and dodging over. I was a bit confused by it myself.
I was like, are you really going to do that? Like, I'm not going to say anything because I'll be happy to trigger as many dodges as that does. But it didn't say anything, so that was weird.
I think the match I want to see is Thomas versus Lucas, because that's like Spanity versus Chaos right now.
No, I want to see Thomas versus Dan.
Yeah, but that's just Chaos versus Chaos.
Yeah, I know. Exactly. That's why I want to see Thomas versus Dan. It's just going to be stupid.
Yeah.
Of course he did.
That's true.
Oh. The weird leaning here.
It's true. Thomas is now Raiden, according to Hellbender, because of that wig.
Raiden?
Yeah, because of that wig.
Oh, yeah. The moth wig.
Yeah, the moth wig.
Because I don't use, like, big guys. I always get Wild Animals is the one where the thing stays, right? He still has a tackle zone.
He still has tackle zones. You can check, because if you click on your players, you can still see there are tackle zones there.
Yeah, true.
Really stupid and Bonehead lose their tackle zones, I think.
Yeah.
Well, Bonehead definitely does, and I'm pretty sure Really Stupid loses their tackle zones as well.
They do. Yep. They do. That's
a GFI. Is there another negatrade? Nope.
What?
Is there another negatrade?
Bonehead, Really Stupid, Wild Animal.
I mean, there are the really brutal ones, but they're not in the game yet.
Oh yeah, I guess of course Bloodlust is of course one.
I would say Titchy is a really bad name.
Yeah, Titchy's hilarious.
What's that?
Titchy is what Snotlings have, and it's basically they never they have tackle zones, but the tackle zones don't do anything.
Yeah, I remember. Wait, why are there tackle zones if they don't?
Because if you don't have tackle zones, you can't catch the ball and stuff like that.
Shit.
Oh. Okay.
What was the last thing you were saying?
Trying to move
the
miners at the back to get them into positions so the elves had more dodge dice to do.
You're in a pretty strong... You do have a strong hold right now, though, which is nice.
Yeah, I had to use a reroll to do the GFIs, but yeah.
It was pretty good, though, because then the other guy just fucking YOLO'd in with GFIs as well.
Yeah. Just trying to make the dodges as hard as possible, really.
They're pretty difficult. I mean, what, there's two tackle zones on the ball.
Yeah.
There's, like, in this middle bit, there's, like, multiple two tackle zones layered over each other if there's no block. Plus, they're Chaos Warriors, so the blocks are even harder because there's no, like, guard or anything to, be able to add in an assist.
I'm just going to point out, in case people aren't aware as well, that the mutation is kind of like bone Wolverine claws. It's rather interesting.
Yeah, yeah. It's literally the orc. It's the orc blitzer.
Yeah.
It's not. Yeah, they're even more bone. They're like spines.
I thought when I first saw it, but it was literally it wasn't even a mutation. He was just like wearing an iron knuckle with claws on it. I was just like, yeah.
I like how he has the claws, but when he dodges out, he just I'm gonna use my feet.
Yeah, he's just gonna drop kick instead. It's like, why did you have the claws? What was the point of this?
Ooh.
Oh, did we have the Brave?
Yeah.
Here we fucking go.
No.
That's okay.
Planned.
Like seriously, after all the bloody bounces I've seen from Madden, I'm just worried every time that ball starts bouncing.
Bounces may or may not have happened in the final as well.
I wouldn't be surprised if it did. Oh, here we go. Is that going to the Mino? Mino? Is that going to the?
Oh, we don't know. We don't see it until after 3-year-old. 50-50.
I rolled the same dice again though.
That Chaos Warrior really likes
it. I'll take it!
It's in a better place. The Witch Elf is still sleeping, though.
the Lawlth didn't have a chance to stand up.
It just kind like of continues her strength. Oh, really? Right. The dad.
See, Pete clearly doesn't believe in the bouncers. That's his problem.
The armor 7.
Got a KO.
Yeah. I'm guessing you're going like Mighty Blow or something, or Pylon with that guy next if he doubles.
Probably Mighty Blow first.
No, Donahad needs a lot to level up.
Yeah.
He needs 14 points to level up.
Yeah.
Oh, he has agility 3, so he doesn't need break tackle.
That's like my book. Lucas, are you the same person we just like? Oh yeah, no. Oh, okay, yeah. Instead of break tackle, you're gonna take. All right, I get it.
Yep. Now you're getting me. That's a double. Because you see, Chaos Warriors have access to very long legs.
Lucas has discovered that this is a thing that's quite good. Because it allows you to get +1 on interceptions.
That's what he likes.
God, Thomas is going into like ranked multiplayer right now on Blood Bowl.
What team?
Oh, I don't even fucking know. Yeah, what team did you make, Thomas? Did you make a team? God.
I need to make a team.
Shit.
Outer complete.
Maybe he took a one of the starter teams.
Oh, maybe he just did the built a team and just like did the coach choices.
Yeah. I love the fact that.
Get the fuck down.
All right, mate. It's just a game.
It's just a game. Getting really angry really early on. It's literally 4 turns into the first half.
This isn't anger.
You're winning.
This is Pete being forceful. Didn't you get two? Is the reason you have loners because didn't you get like two?
I've got two loners. Movement?
No, yeah, but I mean, didn't you have another beastman with plus movement, or am I misremembering?
No, I've only got one beastman with plus movement.
Okay.
Thomas, what race are you playing? I want to know.
Yeah, I also want to know. We'll see if he tells us.
Let's see if he knows.
Nick, what is it with your games and just ending up in a blob?
I don't know.
I mean, his elves are
pretty cool. I'm Pete, who literally, his idea of a cage is a 3x3 packed full of men.
True. Pete does focus on one area, so...
Oh no, Josh, you discovered my plan to blob all of my dudes in one small square. Oh no.
Oh no.
My plan has come undone.
We discovered that strat in season 1.
The only... Not really, because throwing a goblin across a field was not everybody in one blob.
No, but you super caged, like, very often.
Yeah, that's true. You did use the super cage a fair amount.
I did, and it
was slightly different that time though, because you put like black ox on the corners and then like blitzes.
This is
like,
just
one
this
out.
Is just I have the ball and I've been punching elves.
Yeah, no, I understand. It's just a blob of people who want to hit elves.
And those who want to hit elves.
Also, Nick's aren't just... Nick dwarf coach?
What?
Like, he plays, he mains dwarves.
Oh, maybe? I don't know, do you?
That's annoying.
What? That's sorry? Annoying.
Do you main, what's your main team usually, dwarves?
I usually play Amazons or dwarves. Amazons is more like, I play better with dwarves, I just like Amazons.
I can tell, like, your playstyle is very dwarfish.
Which is why I want to play dwarves season 3.
Fine by me.
I think that would fit you very well, yeah. from what I've seen.
He picked Chaos, is what Thomas picked. Chaos.
Of course, Thomas picked Chaos.
Of course.
It's a pretty good team to begin
it's
with.
It's not. It's not. It's like a. That's a really bad team to start with.
It really is.
Could be worse. Could be worse.
No, he absolutely. Oh no, actually.
Like they don't have many stats. They don't have many roles. I'll give you that. But they have pretty good stats. That's.
Yeah, but they're also really weak early on. Like really weak.
I wouldn't say they're really weak. I'd say that they get really strong at endgame rather than they're really weak at the start. I think their stats make up for the early game deficiency of lack of abilities.
They're comparatively really weak compared to the teams that are really strong at Team V 1000, then.
I mean, do the billion dodge one. I appreciate that one.
Who would you say the best starter teams, then?
Humans and orcs.
For the new players, humans are actually really good to start with.
I would say
one of the elf teams would probably, teams would probably be the best one to go into, other than orc or human.
Yeah, I would say orc or human, maybe high elves, but I would say orc and human are the two best starting teams, just because they're so just generally all round.
Yeah, I would agree on that. High elves are almost there.
Yeah, I'd say when you start to learn a game, you should probably learn ball handling before, like, bashing. Blocking. Yeah, bashing.
Bashing's, like, in theory, easier.
Has Lincoln Porter taught you, or did he literally learn nothing throughout the whole league?
He just hasn't learned anything. He's been
He was new. Like, he wasn't in my starting three.
Well, you started with three, didn't you? Yeah. with three. He's been around for a while.
Unlike my witch elf, who literally has been me since the game one and has 5 SPP because she got one-time MVP.
Okay,
unfortunately, Hellbender, Thomas can't join the Cripple Cup because it is a one-day tournament that only runs occasionally, and it's currently not running.
Is he going to, like, refund the game now?
No, Hellbender was saying Thomas should join the Cripple Cup.
Thomas bought the game to join the Cripple Cup, can't, therefore refunds the game immediately.
God, you know what would be stupid? Getting a Minotaur with fucking...
Did you forget that you were Juggernaut for a second?
No.
No, it doesn't knock around.
I was seeing if she had dodge, is what I was doing.
Yeah, which is had dodge by default.
Yeah, I did.
Minotaur's actually in a really good place now. It's tying up so many things.
If only he had guard.
No, if only he had tentacles.
Yeah, tentacles or prehensile tail.
Yeah, that
probably tentacles.
That was the second decision to go to get something. Unfortunately, I wanted, knowing that I was going to be going into a semi difficult game. I wanted to pick a skill that would benefit me in the long run. So that will benefit me over three games.
Is that a really subtle shade you're throwing there, Pete?
No, it's not shade at all. Like, you were right. You said it at the beginning of the game that I lost to you. And so it's going to be a relatively difficult game.
Yeah, he's not saying you're a terrible person, like terrible opponent or anything. He's treating you as a legitimate threat to, like, and he needs to deal with it.
Definitely not saying that you're a terrible person.
That's you, Ronith.
No, I agree. Ronith is a terrible person.
Ronith is calling me a terrible person.
I agree with that as well. Ronith.
I did beat him 6 races to Sunday, so he kind of feels bad about that.
What? It was a fun game.
It was a really fun game, but you were really salty about it.
I mean, Ronith is protesting. It was a fun game.
But it was.
What is this?
Hey, at least Ronith didn't concede.
And you would be sad too.
I have no shame about that concede. They're getting up
close and personal. All the
time. I would. Need to be
close. Such dishonor.
I'm in the tournament for fun. At that point, the game was just not fun. I couldn't do anything. So I peaced out. I'd already lost the first game.
Down you go.
It's almost like I've got armor 9 in this game, and it's not paper.
You don't. You have armor 8.
Yeah, that's where you win. That's
no, what, my Chaos Warriors clearly have armor value 9.
Yeah, the goats have armor 8, though. I will say, in the dwarf versus orc game, armor 9 did not turn up a lot.
Yeah.
Fucking black orcs Black Ox have armor too, for fuck's sake.
Sauras, they have armor zero.
Is that why they kept killing themselves?
Yes. That is exactly why.
Also, I want to point out that I agree with the chat. Currently, it's hashtag Spiffy.
What the fuck does that mean?
Spiffy? Spiffy is the small dog from Monkey Island 1. And when we found him in Monkey Island 1 on streaming, like, everyone just started spamming hashtag Spiffy.
Okay.
Have I seen that?
I mean...
Oh, I don't know. Were you watching me stream?
I mean, that's an interesting move.
I don't think it is.
Really?
I was just wondering if we did that watch piece, when dude, we seriously. Were playing through
Go away. Go the hell away. Judith Cleric is technically my best blitzer. Like, skills-wise...
But he's
and
awful.
Every single time, he screws up.
I know. He's got blood.
He's one sidestep. And Judith Cleric has spent so many times on the floor. It's unbelievable.
He's like the owner
he's
of the team.
He's married to the friggin' witch elf.
No, I was gonna say like he's the owner. He's the team's owner. Like he's the son of the team's owner, and so like he just keeps getting all the perks and stuff.
Nobody really likes.
Judith Cleric is like 50-50. Like he's. Really? You have no brave.
You're fucking elves!
You did good!
I'm not fucking elves, I am an elf. I sleep with things that aren't elves.
That's not true. Dark elves sleep with other dark elves.
What's the last one? I can't see what it is.
it is...
And I was like, please! Oh.
Oh, wait, you didn't blitz, did you?
I did fucking blitz, I'm not dumb.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he did blitz.
I wasn't sure, because I didn't see the blitz come up, because...
Is Juggernaut only on a blitz, then?
Yeah, Juggernaut's only on a blitz.
Yeah.
Okay. I tell you something... So, Greg's death roller leveled up, by the way, and I will tell you one thing. If you think a big guy with, like, two set icons is obscuring everything, you should see a death roller with three lines of things obscuring.
Oh, come on.
I feel like the grass has been more deadly this game.
Did you roll it or just let him down? Okay.
No, I didn't. I'm not going to use the apothecary in the first half. I'm presuming you didn't either.
No.
No, I didn't think so.
Well, to be fair, all I got is knockouts.
The assassin is minus one...
Minus one movement or armor value.
That's how little I care about him. I didn't even realize that he'd taken
down. He got a negative in a stat.
Yeah.
I actually think it might be negative agility. I think
no, it was movement or armor.
It was movement.
Yeah.
Movement allowance, yeah.
So shadowing just became worse.
Oh yeah, because shadowing is the main thing. That's what Nick had him.
I've watched that. Shadowing was the reason he was
so
there.
So many people, ineffectually. Quite sad.
Yeah, the witch elf is terrible. Nick's two best players are the witch elf and Judith Cleric, and they're both awful.
Like, thing is, this game, she's done stuff. It's just it's too little too late. Like, she's consistently knocked people down now.
That's true. She hasn't double-skulled herself repeatedly. That is true.
Yeah.
So, do you have any, like, likely levels up this, Pete? Or Nick?
Maybe if I decide to be risky with the book... Yeah. Sake. If I decide to be risky with a ball, I could probably try and get Lincoln Pork Sausage up.
Yeah, because he's on fire.
Yeah,
mistake,
but
right?
I've got no rerolls this half, so I don't really want to risk it. I'd rather just get the definite score.
I definitely want to do it this half. Not with two turns to go and like a bunch of elves there.
I'm presuming you mean definitely score.
I mean definitely don't risk it.
There are a lot of statements there that the
Lucas, I can finally say this. Lucas, you're out of the tournament. How did your risks take you?
Pretty far, actually. And I lost because my opponent took risks.
Not true. You lost because 100%.
He took a really huge risk and won because of it.
It's true. I think he also did the same to me.
Fuck it. I think we just score. I don't think you can do anything with one turn.
I can't cross the pitch. I'm not that silly.
But this is the question: do your three elves roll once?
Let's find out.
Got zero, one, three, two pluses. How many stay down? Oh, none of them. Thank God for that.
Every single KO just got back up. Every single one.
Oh, including my...
Yeah, including yours. All of your KOs got up and all of Nick's KOs
cool.
got up.
Cool, so at least... the question is, was my babe useful?
Let's find out. Celtic Toast, no, that's a 4+. Moda, hit another thing. Mayhem, that's a 5+.
So no.
No.
Were mine useful?
Panic out. Yeah. Yes. Yep. You rolled a 2. The other 2 weren't, but you did need it for a panic. So.
Yeah, panic out is my one of my blockers, I think. Or is he a blodge piece?
I think.
No, he's the block piece. I do know. I gave the brothers panic at the disco. One has block. One has dodge.
Together, they make one competent player.
I think we do this, and just in case a blitz happens, or yeah, no, not a blitz. Something else. A riot. That's the one I'm looking for.
I want to say something, but I feel like if I say it, it's going to happen and Pete's going to get angry with me, so...
You mean like every time?
Angry anyway.
Yeah, pretty much.
No, I mean not every time I get angry with you, but every time you say something. Right, the ball has been kicked. What were you going to say?
I was going to say, there hasn't, like, the finals have been very weather-free, apart from there was a bit of rain at one point. Maybe finally Blizzard will turn up.
Thanks.
I mean, we've had everything else.
Who actually got the injury on my minor beastman?
Someone who was running away. He was running away from the disco, maybe.
Yeah, but you don't get SPP for it.
Didn't I?
No, you don't get it. If he falls over from a dodge, no one gets the SPP for it. If anything, the pitch gets the SPP for it.
Pitch OP, yeah.
Yeah, it really is.
That's what happens when the pitch levels up.
Kill two of my players.
Kill too many players. Stadium levels up. Yeah.
The pitch has pitch killed two of Lucas's players. It killed at least one skink last season. Look at that head. Yes, the unmistakable sign
of a player's eyes rolling up into his head. Well, that was really good for me. Scored on my opponent's drive. What do I do? Is this get as many elves on the Mino as possible?
Maybe.
Right now, Nick is wishing he could stab it.
Probably. I am. Oh, yeah. I'm really sad that he got literally... He came in, missed the stab, essentially, is what happened.
He killed himself.
Yeah, pretty much is what happened.
He just sort of ran over with holding his knife above his head, like in the classic serial killer pose, and the Minotaur was bending down to tie his shoe, and he just ran and impaled himself on one of the horns.
Makes sense.
Wow, Nick has 3 rerolls left.
Yeah, well, yeah. We both got a reroll at the start of this kickoff, so...
That's true, but it's still kind of crazy.
Yeah,
he did that badly.
Well, you got to remember that one of his turnovers was a failed dodge with a dodge skill.
Yeah, that's true.
So there wasn't any way of coming out of that, which, to be fair, is a pretty pivotal moment.
That is true.
I mean, thanks for giving my Mino someone to punch. I mean, I appreciate it.
Yeah.
It's fine. It's the disco. He has dodge. He's invincible.
I was wondering if you're going to go for the vanity pass.
Might as well.
Oh, that's an extra SVP, and he vanity passes next time. You get a level 3 lineman, don't you? Who knows, he might roll plus armor.
Wow.
Yeah, you don't get SVP for that one, I'm afraid.
No! Point me to one of an SVP, it'll add up eventually. I want my main player back.
What, the assassin?
No, my strength 5 blitzer, who are you going to meet next game?
Sorry, Thomas
oh,
just...
Oh yeah, you have that.
That Thomas linked a picture of how his game's going. It's pouring rain. His team's lying down.
To be fair.
How? Sorry. How do I get three dice? Is it three times the strength value?
No, it's double plus one.
So all I have to do is move one beastman. Okay.
You should be able to. Yeah.
No, that doesn't give me three die.
Five, six. No, yeah, because he's strength three. It's double plus one. You need.
Oh, double plus one. Oh. We just do that then.
Yeah, you need an extra person. That gives you three.
It does.
Can't see anything.
And that gives you another three.
Ugh. That's pretty shit, actually.
That wasn't a blitz either, was it?
No. Well, it doesn't matter, because it would have been a push anyway, so...
That's true. But I just meant if you'd rolled, like, a bunch of double downs. Guy in chat asked Thomas, is his team's learning how to swim?
Yeah, I was waiting for that.
You gotta reroll that.
Yeah, I know, I'm gonna use it anyway. Ah, for fuck's sake.
Well, at least he didn't kill himself on the pit.
Yeah, that was more the reason I was doing the reroll, to be honest with you.
That is the first half.
Yep.
Beastman's back up.
Cool, I didn't have anyone down, so...
Oh, that poor little assassin who's in the fetal position.
Is he in the... He's got like broken ribs or something, hasn't he?
I thought he had a broken back.
It's whatever it is that... If he's got a broken back, then the fetal position is not a very good position to be in.
I mean, it is, because his back's broken. That's why he's in that position.
But you meant to like straighten it out or something, I suppose.
Thomas is saying he's just hitting my players and the guy with the ball is running in circles. Yeah, that sounds about right. He's stalling part of Blood Bowl. I mean, he's probably being a dick as well because he's realized you're a very new player and then he's just like, aha, I can just take advantage and be a douchebag. Probably what's happening.
A douchebag?
SPP farming.
But he's not SPP farming, he's just running the ball in circles.
Maybe he wants to punch things.
That's true. Thomas is like, I think I lost.
Bless him.
Ooh, very long legs also counters the safe throw skill.
Yes.
It also gives you plus one to leap. It's like the only thing in the game that gives you plus one to leap.
I know. But I didn't know about the plus one on interceptions.
Yeah.
And preventing safe throw.
I knew that. The problem is that you've got to be able to place that one player in key positions every time.
Or
you play slam.
That's because you play slam because all of them have very long legs.
Well, yeah, there is that.
I can't wait for that team to come out.
They're not going to come out for so long though, because I mean they're not they're like not even in like the basic races. They're like in the testing races as well. So it's like they're not going to come out for so long. I agree with you, though, because they'll be amazing.
No, probably not. But
amazing doesn't mean good. Amazing doesn't mean good,
all right? Let's just get that sorted out.
Like, well, I'll clarify. I think the vampire team is amazing.
You would.
And they're god-awful.
Fill you with awe. Not necessarily the good kind or the bad kind of awe.
Exactly.
Let's do that, actually.
Dwarfs aren't cheesy. They're just very good at low team value.
Dwarfs are drunk.
Yeah, dwarfs are drunk. Interesting strategy, Pete.
Yeah.
Operation put my entire team on the floor again.
Well, you can only hit four people.
I recognize it.
It's fine, Nick. He can only hit four people.
Be gone, fell demon. Where's that ball going? Hey, nice weather. Thank you. That's not too bad. I can live with that.
That's pretty good for you.
It was very good for me. Well, that should give me two die. This is gonna be enough. And that's that blitz from his ass.
No, he's not. He's got blotch.
No, I've got tackle.
But you still get to go pick where he falls over, Nick.
Yeah, and your time is ending.
I love sidestep for just the really dumb, like, animation stuff that happens. It's so good.
Wow. And... okay, there it is.
Well, no, I was expecting the both downs on the skull.
Yep.
Yeah, drunk means dwarves can ignore head injuries, hence thick skull on all of them. It's true. I mean, it's a pretty good start for you, Pete. In terms of the best of three, I mean,
absolutely. But it's
things. I'm looking at this. And I'm like, damn it! I want to go to bed relatively early.
Thanks, mate.
Well, I do. I've got stuff in the morning. So
here we go.
Yep. I'll be right back. I'll just let the camera auto do it. Hopefully it'll be fine.
I like how you're relying on that camera. And that we all know, okay, we all know that that camera is fucking garbage.
Look, Pete, there are four spaces around the ball carrier. They're still empty.
I know, right?
Pete is super cage. He's not a wizard.
This is true.
To be fair, the wizard was so good last time. I don't care about not having a wizard anymore.
Excuse me.
You're excused. Really? Okay.
I return.
Hi.
Everything went to hell when you were gone, by the way. It was actually quite despairing.
Fair enough. Unfortunately, you can't play throwing dwarfs. None of the dwarfs have the right stuff, which is a shame, because that would be a very funny team.
That is true. Let's go for it.
I have no... I do not believe! I do not believe! I'll do.
I believe...
I mean, for someone that doesn't believe, you did alright.
Yeah.
My lack of belief is very strong, believe me.
What was I gonna say? Yeah, I mean, the closest you can get to throwing, like, a throwing dwarf team is halflings, because that's literally what that team does, because they're terrible
at
everything, including throwing.
Garbage!
Yeah, halflings are real garbage.
I mean, there's ogres.
There is ogres.
Yeah, ogres cut. I guess ogres also throw. I was about to say ogres can't throw. It's like, oh yeah, they have snotlings, they can throw snotlings. Yeah, the closest, like, an old throwing team, the closest you have is, at least throwing people, is either goblins, which aren't in the game yet, ogres, which aren't in the game yet, or halflings, which aren't in the game yet.
Okay. What the fuck do we do?
Nobody knows.
I don't know, to be honest.
I think that's the best idea. Fuck.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah. That's better.
Yeah, at least it wasn't a loner.
Well, that was why I was looking. Oh, come on. Ah. Too hopeful to ask for an injury after that, wasn't it?
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Hey, you're the one that wanted to go to bed.
Yeah. Keep getting turnover, Thomas. Yep, that sounds about right for someone who's new to Blood Bowl and doesn't really understand how the game works. Basically, if you fuck something up, your turn hard ends. Like, that's part of what makes Blood Bowl, like, very unforgiving and very sort of hard to learn, because a lot, like, basically you have to know what things are safe to do and what things aren't safe to do.
No, don't do that.
Do it, the game... do it. Have the brave. Have the brave. Pass to the Minotaur.
Oh, if Pete could score with his Minotaur, I think he would. I mean...
Oof. That's a lot of fucking elves on the floor.
My Blood Bowl just crashed. Just did my orbs.
It makes no difference if that's there. So, what the fuck do we do?
That's not good.
I want to get to there. That's what I want to get to. Okay, alright, you go there. I need to start making moves.
I'm loading back into the game as quick as I can.
Orbs crashed or Blood Bowl crashed?
The display drivers crashed, which crashed Orbs and Blood Bowl, apparently.
Oh, lovely.
You've missed two turnovers. There's been three injuries.
No!
The Minotaur's dead.
This is the
Witch Elf.
That is unfortunate.
Every single block we've rolled so far has resulted in a dead.
No! I'm loading back in now.
Yeah. I mean, I don't really know what I could do other than that.
Switch view. Let's go back to where the view you're in. Alright, we should all be back now.
I mean, I hope I've caged up as much as I can. I mean, either side, it was going to be a bit of a pain, but... You can't blitz everything, unfortunately.
No.
No, that is true.
I say unfortunately, I do mean fortunately, you can't blitz everything.
It's unfortunate for you, but Pete is fucking happy about it.
Yes and no. I'm really, position-wise, not in a good place right now.
No, but you're still happy you can't get blitzed multiple times.
Yeah.
I'm trying to basically damage mitigation as much as possible, because something needs to happen now, and it's not going to be a pleasant experience.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Do it.
Because this is me relying on a bloody double red.
That's fine.
Lucas plays.
Your potential test rate, probably.
And it's on someone that can't bloody roll a...
Oh, is it on a lock?
No, there's a guy who doesn't have block, which is unfortunate.
He's doing it with Thedisco.
No, I'm just surprised he moved that last guy, because if he actually got him down... Pan would have been able to grab the ball and hoist it.
Well, that really depends where the ball would have went.
Well, yeah, but if it came free at all.
Take it.
Sure.
I will do when you. Thank you. Ah, fuck.
Yes,
okay.
Please.
Yeah.
time to play the game we call Removing Tackle Zones.
Yep.
Oh, there he is. I was wondering where your IG4 Chaos Warrior was, but yeah.
Down last turn.
I'm guessing the reason you chose Lincoln Pork Sausage to carry the ball is because you really want that level up.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. Since this is the risky fucking play.
Now it's just a simple matter of getting the ball at their feet. It's never simple.
Don't know.
Yep.
Yeah.
The ball is surrounded. Sort of.
Kinda. Ball surrounded, maybe.
It may or may not be surrounded. Oh.
There goes your last reroll.
Oh shit, I didn't see that piece there. Fuck.
Which guy have you not noticed?
I thought the miner was free. He's not.
Oh, no. There's, My Chemical Romance.
Yeah.
It's fine, he hit an elf.
Yeah, but I wanted to move him into a better position.
Yeah, but you know he would have wild animal if you tried that.
Oh no, absolutely. But unfortunately, I just wanted pieces in a better position right now.
I wouldn't say he's in a bad position right now.
Fuck, that's annoying. I forgot that was a sidestep piece.
It's fine, he's going on his ass.
No, that's true, and I was hoping that the claw would do some damage. But I really should have. Fuck.
Damn, boy.
Okay. Well, I'm in the thankful thing that there's a few elves on the floor. But that doesn't stop him elfing, to be completely honest.
That does look like it should hurt them, shouldn't it?
What, double dropkick? Yeah.
Yeah, it's like they miss, they hit nothing, and just lands a flate on their faces. Like, that doesn't sound clever.
The pitch should kill them.
Pitch needs to earn SVP.
How long has your witch elf been on the deck, then?
Just a turn. Oh, wow. It got stunned last turn.
That was only last turn. It seems so long ago.
It's because Nick and I are playing a very thoughtful game. Well, fuck.
That allows for elfiness.
That could be bad. That could be very bad.
So I do want to point out that for people who may not remember, that this will go into golden goal if it tries to draw, because in a best of three you can't draw. Also, I learned something about Golden Goal. Happened to encounter... That was interesting pathing.
That was interesting pathing indeed.
You don't get your... I thought you got your rerolls back.
No, you don't.
Yeah, that was a nasty surprise. I was like, oh, shit.
We did tell you in the previous game.
Yeah, that was a while ago, though.
It was last week!
Yeah, that's a while ago.
Realize it was a loner. Blast it.
Curses.
Oh, is that? I was wondering why.
Are you going to pass to Anlin?
Yeah, that's what I.
Flood it.
I mean.
Oh, he's just going for the water bomb.
Oh, really? Come on!
No, that would have been an inaccurate pass. He wasn't going to fumble it. You didn't actually need to reroll that. think.
We should told you that much.
Well, there it does the animation of you failing the pass because, yeah, like that pass was going to fail. You only fumble it if you roll a one and you rolled a three.
Interesting thing is, it's not really clear what it rolls at the bottom of the screen for me.
Shit. Good boy, good boy.
Good doggy.
Meh.
Like, should that be good sheepy?
Goat, I think. Goat, ideally. Good goatee, good goatee.
Oh no, oh no. Chaos, those are the guys who can do fucking throw plays. That's what I learned from fucking Dan.
Cute animals like this forget the sport and embrace their wild side.
Excuse me.
Have that.
Oh, it's my choice. I keep forgetting.
Yeah, I've noticed that.
I'm not used to having a sidestep.
No, it's fine. No, I completely understand. All I'm saying is that I've noticed that you're not aware of it.
Came back.
Hello.
No, that's fine.
Hey, Ronnie.
I'll have that.
I unmuted myself and you guys couldn't hear me still. That was weird.
That's fine. We hear you now. I would say, like, that sidestep was pretty good there because it puts him exactly in the way, even though he's on his ass.
Yeah, well, I'm not moving this. I'm not moving this turn.
Yeah, I figured.
That was so many dice I got so lucky with. Jesus.
So many dice.
Yeah, it just if you did want to like run out that turn, that sidestep would have prevented you, or it would have made it way harder at least. Because he's in the perfect position to be in the way. This is
going to be decisive. Absolutely.
Sidestep, good ability. The cage is broken.
For now.
Gates.
That reminds me of the gates are open. I hate you.
I know, that was literally
that
the
was
point.
Literally the point. He is.
I hate you even more.
Why?
Because it reminds me of the good game that doesn't exist anymore.
Guess, yeah.
Oh, yeah, the game.
I missed Dawngate. That was a great game.
Yeah, it was an amazing game.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, she's coming back into the fray.
Is she? Or is she just going to keep lying on her ass?
I mean, if she wants to stay down there for even more turns, I'm not gonna like, dissuade.
I was kind of expecting... I mean, I guess he has to get the ball, but I was kind of expecting Nick to like run her further down and just try and long bomb it down to her.
Yeah, that's what I was expecting.
I was, but I did it the wrong way around.
Yeah, you meant to get her up first.
Yeah. And then that other guy was the loner. Oh, that works out.
Yeah, I'll take that.
But you still do have a lot of elves on the floor, unfortunately. Alright, yeah, but Pete's not going to make you turn over. That makes sense, I guess.
I don't want to drop the ball again. It was a pain in the ass last time.
Yeah, no, you're like it would probably have scattered all the way down this chain of elves and ended up in the hands of...
You mean all the way down the chaos and got to a nice tasty position for the elves to pick it up? Yep.
Really?
Apparently. Yeah, apparently you like to roll ones.
You have no idea. No idea. I do like to roll ones, very much so.
Rolling ones is the way forward.
Clearly. Yeah.
So much so that when I play craps, I bet. Damn it, I forgot the name of the bets now. It's the one that requires you to roll ones.
Snake Eyes?
Yeah, that's the name of the roll, but there's...
I know nothing about craps.
Why'd you do that? You bet there are bets to succeed, then there are bets to fail, essentially.
So you always bet on failing.
Pretty much. kind of like that Minotaur there.
Minotaur is just, he's real angry at these two elves lying on the ground.
It's like, they are in front of me. I am seeing two elves down, but there's only should be one there. Are they the same elf? Literally, he's usually like the bulls again.
Interesting. Why did you go for the dodge rather than like hitting with the claw piece?
I forgot he was in the tackle zone.
No. That works too.
No! No! What the fuck was that? Oh, there's an elf there.
There's an elf in the middle.
Bollocks.
You can foul him, it's fine.
Wait, which elf did you miss?
The one between the Mino and the Chaos Warrior.
Yeah, that's an elf there.
Totally there. Like,
don't hurt me.
I see Nick is employing the wood elf tactics of just hiding elves everywhere.
Elves are really good at hiding.
Okay, so I fucked that up, so I need to do a shit cage. Makes sense.
Hashtag shit cage.
Hashtag shit cage.
Hashtag spiffy.
No.
Fucking spiffy.
It's my stream. I can do whatever I want.
It's my game. You can stop talking shit.
Nah.
Okay.
I will always talk shit in your games, Pete.
Yeah, I love that. That's a strike made with
technique and precision. That claw has not done a lot.
Incorrect. It got stunned on the very first turn.
It's yeah, because an armor roll of 8 or more automatically breaks armor, and his team is armor 8 maximum.
No, that's not. No,
that's not how it works at all.
His armor, his team is eight armor, which means that
An armor roll of 8 or more breaks armor, and his team is armor 8, so yes, it would only be a minuscule number of cases where it would actually help.
No, it helps in every case. You're not listening. What that means on claw is it means that it
Nick,
reduces
it's
their armor
for you
to
choose. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. You're gonna have to keep reminding me.
No, that's fine.
To break armor,
deliberately trying to delay the game or anything. I just like, what am I doing again?
Break armor 8. You need to roll 9, Madden.
Yeah, I know. But I mean, because he's rolling crap, it's not helping him. And it's not like there's any armor 9 or 10 guys.
Oh,
it's
wow.
Reducing. It's
that's not
his
happening.
Armor breaks slightly more lightly.
That's true, but if I had won the match against Nick, he would have been up against Soros and Crocs. And
oh, yeah. It'd be solid against them, because it'd be really
so,
which
really
was
good.
It was entirely the choice of picking Claw, is that because he's Dark Elves. And because I played my game before Ronif played his game, it was a safe choice because it was good either way.
Yeah. Reducing stuff to armor 7, even if they're already on the armor 8, reducing it to armor 7 is still good.
Still mighty blow.
Especially
awesome.
Yeah, if he gets mighty blow, then he's just gonna get a 6 or a 7 plus, which is average.
It's insane.
Yeah.
Which is why Claw mighty blow.
Claw mighty blow pylon is really annoying.
I was expecting that one when that thing turned up.
He goes right back down, it's fine.
What do I do here? I do that. I have to do that.
Elves everywhere, just like in Nam.
Just like in Nam?
That's actually probably the better play.
They're everywhere.
Yeah.
Coming out of the bushes.
Coming out of the trees!
Stay.
Sit down.
I like that. That's fine.
Oh.
Shit.
Oh, sidestep.
Yeah. I didn't see where he went.
He's going to directly towards
that's because
you.
Because he's doing it right.
He's going directly next to you. Yeah.
Shit.
There's a Chaos Knight in the way.
Where is he? Okay, fine. We're gonna have to do this a different way then.
Oh, interesting. Cool.
Of course, the fucking tackle piece gets the fucking pow. You piece of shit.
Oh, interesting. Because I can sidestep. I can't be pushed in. You can't do.
Yeah.
Elaborate push plays.
Yeah, to fucking surf a sidestep piece, you literally need to block every point around them. So like they're basically impossible to surf.
Unless you really want to dedicate to surf.
Yeah, but if you're dedicating like 8 players to surf a piece, that feels a bit inefficient.
A bit.
Be fair, you also have to get in the position. Yeah, you're gonna have to dedicate the pieces because it's pretty to get the guy to the position where you can surf him is gonna be tricky enough as it is.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, pieces with sidestep are like impossible to.
You are fucking useless right now, aren't you?
Wow, that Minotaur has just not been happy. It's fine. Doesn't matter. Made the dodge anyway. I guess you would have had to make a dodge either room for Minotaur.
No, yes. Itself. Yes, I would. But would have thought the Minotaur would have been a little bit more sensible.
Oh, yeah. No, having the Minotaur hit something is absolutely correct. Night, Thomas.
Thomas, panic at the disco.
No, Thomas is leaving.
I'm also panic that right next to the disco.
Of course, they're brothers. Between them, they are one capable player, maybe, sometimes.
Yeah. Well, between them is a capable player.
I like it.
I mean, is it time for even more YOLO plays, is it?
I'm not sure.
I mean, you kind of have to, because the nice thing, like, this is still, like, inverted commas, winnable for you, because you just need to make a draw happen. It's difficult, but basically because you don't need to score twice in this, you just need to score once to force it into golden goal that you have a chance still.
Feel like rolling a 1, then I rolled a 2 there, that was nice. I appreciate that.
Ooh. You are rolling a lot of ones in this game.
2 is like rolling 2 ones. Think about that one.
I'm really worried about you.
So at this point, you kind of want a warden, so just to jump into the cage.
Yeah.
Because the thing is, even if he gets the red dice block off, he's pushing him towards the line, and nobody else.
You can, yeah, that's true.
That's a ridiculous amount of dodge for a red dice block.
Yes, that was why I was trying to work out how to get the good cage. Finally,
that is. I haven't got a choice though.
I mean. If you don't get the ball out of my hands this turn, I score.
Yeah.
Unless you decide to showboat.
No, I'd be scoring this turn.
Wow. Double ones again.
But that body is now in the way, making my job slightly harder.
The cage is not open.
That was not double ones as well. 3 and 2.
Why were they 5 pluses?
Because you were dodging into 3 tackle zones.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was not an idea for 5 plus. I misread the numbers. As I often do, so it's fine. Is the assist gonna be enough to come out on top? Down, boy.
Fuck!
End of turn.
Ooh.
What was it you said? If you don't get the ball out of my hands this turn, I score.
Wow, the shade.
It wasn't a mistake, it was just... Fuck!
On the plus side, like, it's just the game conspiring to never let Lincoln Pock Sausage level up.
It's listening in to all of our... We're going from Skype to Discord. It's just following us.
Thing is, this is the really bad thing, is that it's still really risky for me to do anything here.
Yeah, at most you can get a 1 dice, and it still requires dodging.
No, I can get a 2 dice. Does it require a dodge?
I'm pretty sure you can't.
No, he can.
He absolutely can.
Oh. Yeah, sorry. We had different blocks in mind.
I'm still not seeing how to get a two dice on this. I can see a 1 dice. I cannot see a 2 dice. Like, every place where you could put an extra off is marked. And you don't have guard.
Hmm. No, I can put an elf there. Though I'm really loath to do that.
He has to put an elf. No, he can't. He knows he can do it.
No, shut up, Madden.
Defensive pressure down. The hell? Yeah, the two dice block. Well,
they had to retreat a little. Oh, right, because then you can block him like that.
Yeah.
Yep.
I just legitimately couldn't see a two dice block in there.
You forgot that the person who does the hit.
No, I didn't. I just didn't see. I didn't realize that.
Really?
Wow, that's unfortunate.
I didn't forget that the person doing the thing doesn't have to assist. I didn't realize you could get in there in the front like that. I was expecting the block to come in from the back, in which case there's no position you can put elves that would get you a three dice because everything is marked.
Yeah, well, that's the end of that. That was really, really bad dice bouncing.
Yeah, you rolled a lot of ones again, for the look of it.
Yeah, but missing the catches is good, because if you'd caught it, the ball would have been... Like, if this guy, Lawlth Prophets, had actually caught it, it would have been locked there, and there would have been nothing you can do about it.
Fuck it.
But if he picks it up with the blitz guy, there's nothing he can do about it anyway.
No, I know. That's what I'm saying. Him catching the ball, not catching the ball with these things.
Yeah, Lawlth Prophets is someone else. That was all.
You got it.
No, Lawlth Prophets is the guy who tried to catch it first.
Yeah, yeah. But I'm saying, like, Jude of Cleric, because he blitzed, even if he picks it up, there's nothing he can do anyway.
No, I agree. It's just it's a different point to the one I was making.
Alright, you get up.
Right, how do I finish? You really should have stood up a few elves.
This is it, isn't it? This is score.
Oh, you went either way.
So. Score or die. Sudden death.
I cannot score, so you win either way.
Shit. Just realized who that was.
Sidestep.
Sidestep.
Be among friends.
I love those animations.
It's the dive kick that sort of like pushes him not the way that the dive kick is aiming.
It wasn't a kick for me, it was a punch.
Fucking Christ. With
fists flailing, he's following up. It's a push.
On the plus side, it's... At least this, you don't have to do this to win, so that's nice. Like I said, it's the fates just conspiring to never let Lincoln Pork Sausage actually level up.
Before you get the MVP.
I was going to say that, like 10 minutes
Nick.
Ago.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you. Right, well, okay, time to punch one, two elves. That's
quite a mismatch, Bob. Oh, he succeeded as well, animal fate.
Yeah, of course he did. It's the last turn. He's got a showbot on the last turn to just push up.
He's gonna push elves around for a bit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Foul someone, you know you want to.
Do it.
Killed an elf.
Oh man, if only fucking the witch elf was like two squares further down.
Yep, I know. Tell me about it.
I mean, it wouldn't be likely, but it would be like a fucking YOLO to try and even it.
Just throw the wall to her.
If you could hand off to her, then she passes. She levels.
That's not happening. That is not happening. You realize that, right? There is no possible way to get Judith Cleric beside her to hand off.
I like your optimism, Madden.
Like, there is.
There
isn't!
Yeah. I cannot... Dodges one GFI gets you there.
Three dodges.
And you can possibly clear some of the way as well.
It's three dodges.
Gets you there.
Yeah, he can reach, but it's three dodges and a GFI.
I mean, you may as well go for it and try to showboat Nick, so...
Nick's gonna hit stuff, I think.
I'm gonna do something. I have belief.
Okay.
I'm not sure why I have belief, but I have belief.
Oh, you're going for the... Yeah, I see.
Ooh. What was the loud peak a second ago?
What loud peak?
No idea.
I don't know. Something.
I heard somebody scream in my ear.
Yeah,
Yeah, that was.
Yeah. I didn't get anything. So I guess it would have been my mic maybe then, but like.
No, it was something. It was fucking painful. But
yeah, that was really loud. Mean.
Oh well.
Flip.
That's one way to end the turn. Well, and GG, that was a good game. 1-0. Let's see where the MVPs go.
It goes on Sepultuna.
That was a good game for you. I won't say as much for me.
Well, I got the assassin out for the next game, so.
I rolled 6, which I'm happy with.
I rolled a 3. I rolled a 3 again.
Anlan wants to join my team. Anlan can go away.
Turn down that loner. Turn down that loner. Hey, so I got one beastman that leveled up. And well, I got 12. That's not too bad.
Yeah, it's not too bad.
I get nothing right.
Did I get another level up off of that, though?
You got Sepultuna, just him.
Yeah, no. Okay. But yeah, thank you very much for the game, Nick. I guess until next time.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, sure.
Like now, I'm assuming.
I'm signing off for the record for the YouTubes.
Ah, the YouTubes.
Yeah, yes. For the YouTubes.
Goodbye to the YouTubes.
Goodbye to the YouTubes. Till the next time, we'll see you in the next video.